Hello friends, a warm welcome to yet another interesting session on instrumentation and control in power plant industries. In continuation to our journey of mastering flow meters, today let's deep dive into turbine tap flow meters. So in this video we will be discussing about what is turbine tap flow meter, how does it works, its applications, its advantages, disadvantages, everything in detail. What is turbine tap flow meter? Turbine tap flow meter is basically a device for measuring the volumetric flow rate of gases or liquids passing through a pipeline per unit of time. Now the word volumetric flow rate. Volumetric flow rate, we can say, is the volume of fluid that passes through a particular cross section in per unit time. It is generally measured in gallons per minute or cubic meters per second. A simplified scheme of such flow meters consists of basically three parts: mechanical components, which includes turbine, that is the rotor, impeller and blade; electrical components, which are pickup sensor with a transmitter; and the third is a housing, which covers both these mechanical and electrical components. Mechanical components include a turbine, consists of a shaft which is fixed to pipeline, and an impeller. This impeller is a multi-bladed wheel. The wheel is attached to a shaft that rotates on bearing. The blades are made up of ferromagnetic material. Electrical components consist of pickup sensor system. It has either an induction coil or hall sensor or photoelectric cell. And these sensors transmit give signal to a transmitter, that is a signal transmitter, which is further connected to DCS or PLC. An induction coil generates electrical impulses in direct proportion to rotor speed and transfer them into a recording device. If a hall sensor is used, hall sensors are basically magnetic pickups, then the spacing between the rotor and the magnetic pickup varies during rotation due to the gap between the plates. This magnetic pickup basically generates a magnetic field. As the rotor rotates on its axis, this magnetic field is cut and it simply detects the change in the magnetic field and give this signal to the transmitter. Next type is a photoelectric cell. A photoelectric cell also senses the motion of the turbine blades, and it's comparatively very simple. Instead of indirectly measuring an implied current, the sensor produces an electrical pulse as the blade passes through the sensor. The pulses are counted or totalized over a time period to sense the rotational velocity of the turbine. Housing is made up of non-magnetic cast steel, or could be aluminium or even plastic, and contains both a measuring sensor and a rotor. The most common ways of installing this turbine tap flow meters are using flanged connection to upstream and downstream pipeline. Another important part that is worth mentioning is the straightening vanes. We can see at the inlet side of this flow meter, there are these horizontal plates, parallel horizontal plates. These are basically straightening vanes, and the purpose is they are used to evenly distribute the steam jet across all the blades. Another important part is mechanical stabilizers that are mounted in structure to avoid flow turbulence. The frequency with which these changes occur is monitored and sent to the transmitter. The frequency of such signals is directly proportional to the flow velocity. The turbine flow meter equation about this dependence between the flow and the pulse frequency is F is equal to K into Q, where F is the indicator that displays how many pulses the pickup sensor detects per minute or per second, that is per unit time. Q is the volumetric flow, which could be in gallons or meter cube per second, and K is the K factor, basically spatial coefficient, which is the number of pulses per meter cube. Further, the transmitter analyzes the received data and converts them to analog and or digital signal. Now the question is, what is K factor in turbine flow meter? The K factor is a key coefficient that displays the number of pulses per unit volume or mass of the medium. This constant value includes the main characteristics of the substance like viscosity, temperature, etc., and the characteristics of the pipe like diameter. It is necessary for correct display of values in measuring system. After calibration, this K factor is indicated in the product certificate. Now coming to the installation guidelines or requirements. The first thing is, we have to match the flow direction with the arrow mark on the turbine type flow meter. And second is the straight length requirement. Straight length section before turbine flow meter should be at least 10 times the pipe diameter, and downside should be at least 5 times the pipe diameter. Let us say the pipe diameter is 100 mm, then upstream straight length requirement would be 10 times of this 100 is 1000 mm, and downstream it would be 5 times of this pipe diameter, that is 500 mm. Clear? Next, coming to the advantages and disadvantages. Turbine type flow meters are widely used because of their wide flow rangeability, including low flow rates, and they have a very good turn down ratio, which is 35:1. Accuracy level is very good at comparing to their price. So at an economic price, they provide a very good accuracy, simple durable construction, easy to install and maintain, flexible connection to flow instruments for flow control, wide variety of process connections, and they can operate in a wide range of temperature and pressure. Also, low pressure drop across the turbine and provides a convenient signal output. They carry certain disadvantages too. Requires constant back pressure to prevent cavitation. Accuracy is adversely affected by the bubbles in the liquid. And turbine flow meters can be used with clean fluids and gases only. May need to install a strainer. They generally need a strainer if we want to upstream side, we may have to install a strainer to prevent damage from particles. Definitely cannot be used for corrosive fluids, and requires a turbulent flow profile, consistent fluid velocity across the pipe diameter for accuracy. These are very sensitive to fluid viscosity, requires a straighten of pipe before and after the turbine meter to allow swirl pattern in the flow stream to dissipate. And in case of high viscosity fluids, may not function properly. So friends, that was all about turbine flow meters, their principle, their application, their limitation, and their specific installation requirement. Hope I am able to clear the concept well. We will meet you in our next video. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, take care, bye.